Davao City Mayor Sara Duterte Carpio takes her oath as a member of former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo's Lakas CMD Party. By joining the National Party, Duterte Carpio can now run for president in 2022 by replacing the party's current presidential bet, Ana Capella Velasco, was widely seen as a placeholder. The presidential daughter announced her move on social media with only a single sentence for a caption. Lakas CMD President Lady Representative Martin Romualdez administered her oath Thursday night, but Romualdez stayed mum on which position Duterte Carpio will be gunning for next year.
Taking her oath and has formally joined the Lakas CMD. Just leave it at that. She's just taking her oath. And we've not discussed any positions. No further discussions other than the fact that we had a long-standing invitation to her. And it's been a long time in waiting. And we're very, very honored. We're delighted. And we're so, so happy to have Mayor Inday.
Earlier that day, Duterte Carpio also refused to comment on her next plans for the 2022 elections. She only gave this message to her supporters who have been urging her to run for president.
Magpapasalamat ako sa mga supporters ko. And I hope na kung ano mang mga mangyari sa mga sumusunod na mga araw ay maibigay ko sa kanila kung ano yung gusto nila.
The late dictator's son, Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., not backing down from the presidential race. That's amid speculations he might slide down to be Davao Mayor Sara Duterte's vice presidential running mate.
Examine my situation. I have nowhere else to go. I cannot go anywhere, and I cannot change. I will not change parties. I entered this race not to play any of this substitution, play with the rules. I entered this too because I felt I should run for president, and that's what I do.
Unlike Marcos, presidential aspirant Senator Ronald Bato de la Rosa, who's running under President Rodrigo Duterte's PDP Laban Party, says he's willing to withdraw his candidacy for Sara.
Lahat ay naghihintay sa moves niya. Ano yung magiging move niya? Everything will adjust. Ang presidente ang tatakbuhan niya, granting na tatakbo siya under another party, not with PDP Laban. So, andyan pa rin ako, as standard bearer ng PDP Laban. Ang gagawin ko is ko sabi ko si Pangulong Duterte na with all due respect, mag-withdraw ako.
The convener of opposition coalition Isambayan doesn't see Sara Duterte and Bongbong Marcos joining forces in next year's elections. Attorney Howard Calieja says while Isambayan prepared for their tandem, he believes the Davao mayor will also gun for the country's top post since that is what her father would want.
I don't think Duterte would be able to trust Bongbong 100% in the same way that he can trust Sara or Bongo 100%. I think at this point, he can only trust two individuals, either his daughter or Bongo. And I think between the two, the higher ratings is with Sara, and I think he would put his bet on the daughter instead of Bongo, having faring better in survey.
A veteran campaign strategist also believes neither Marcos nor Duterte Carpio will give way given their favorable numbers in pre-election surveys. Whatever happens, Lito Banayo believes it's former President Gloria Macapagal Arroyo who will be the real winner.
Perhaps GMA, who's running unopposed in Pampanga, in her second district of Pampanga, will be assured of the speakership of the House if Sara Duterte becomes president. But I think that's the same assurance that she has gotten from Ferdinand Marcos Jr. if he becomes president. Either way, she wins as the Speaker of the House.
Marcos and Duterte Carpio should share the presidency or could share the presidency. This is one of the suggestions of a Lakas CMB official amid the challenge of picking who to field as their top bet in 2022. Lakas CMB co-chairman and Quezon Governor Danilo Suarez said, Duterte Carpio can have 3 years in office, while the remaining 3 years can be for Marcos Jr.
Mataas ang survey ni BBM eh. I don't know whether baka mag-term share sila. One will sit for 3 years, give way to the 3 years the vice president. So, gigive up na niya. Wala na siya after 3 years. Para sa akin, yung personal na opinion ko sa akin yun. But the decision of the party at the end of the day.
Meanwhile, Duterte Carpio's regional party, Hukbong ng Pagbabago, said they were taken aback with the Davao mayor's decision to leave the party. But the HNP secretary general maintains they will still continue to support her, whatever she chooses to do next.
Siguro, baka just to be safe, para walang conflict, siguro, baka ganun po ang naging decision ni Mayor Sara, na resign muna siya. We wish her all the best, no? And insofar as HNB is concerned, we are very supportive of whatever her decision might be going into the future. No?
Senator Manny Pacquiao also asserting he will pursue his presidential bid next year. Pacquiao says his meeting with President Duterte in Malacanang on Wednesday doesn't change anything.
Walang atrasan, tuloy po ang laban. The meeting with the President was arranged by common friends. It wasn't a political meeting, but it provided us an opportunity to talk about our shared vision for Mindanao. Hindi nagbabago ang panindigan ko sa pagtakbo bilang Pangulo. Dahil ang hangad ko ay ipakulong ang mga kawatan at mabigyan ng trabaho ang milyong-milyong mga Pilipino. Hindi ako trapo mag-isip. Ang panalo ko ang magpapanalo sa buhay ng bawat Pilipino.
Presidential spokesperson Harry Roque described the meeting of the two leaders as a renewal of friendship after a months-long rift that developed from Pacquiao's allegations of corruption within the Duterte administration.
Meanwhile, President Rodrigo Duterte nominates his fraternity brother, Manila prosecutor Ray Bulay, as the new elections commissioner. Bulay is expected to fill up one of the four vacancies in the COMELEC 7-man unbank. In a statement, Malacanang expressed confidence Bulay will help ensure an honest and peaceful elections. Bulay will still have to go through the Commission on Appointments before he can officially sit as COMELEC commissioner. Bulay is a graduate of San Beda Law and a member of the Lex Talionis Fraternitas, along with President Duterte. Apart from being prosecutor, he previously served as commissioner of the Presidential Commission on Good Government. But poll watchdog Contradaya slammed his nomination, saying Bulay has no clear track record in election lawyering and advocacy.